So far, we've created our hero section. Let's make it responsive. So let's click and drag along the edge to test fluidity and responsiveness. We can go down to tablet and do the same thing here. So far on desktop and tablet, it looks fine. On mobile portrait though, things start to get a little cramped, especially as the viewport gets more narrow. There's a solution. We can use grid to make this responsive. So we'll select edit grid. And from there, we'll add another row. When we do that, we can drag any of our content to resize. So for this div block right here, we can grab along the edge and drag down and do the same thing on the top. So we're simply moving that content down to that cell. Same thing with this phone, just drag, now it's huge, resize it one last time, and everything fits in the leftmost column. To reduce the size of the phone a little bit, let's set a maximum width. Let's set it to something like 200 pixels, and that keeps it more reasonably sized. We also don't need that right column anymore. So under columns, we can just hit delete. Now, what do we do about getting everything centered? There are multiple ways to do this, but we want this iPhone to appear in the center. So we can select the parent, the grid parent itself, and affect all its children at once by selecting children and center. That centers the content. And we can mix other properties, like text alignment. We can align everything right to the center. As we resize, it responds to the device width as we'd expect. The real question is, how does all this look in mobile portrait? Well, things are a little more cramped. Our buttons still have that right margin and they're stacking, so let's set that to 0 so it centers, and we can set the width to 100%. Lower margin will help us push off from the bottom, so there's some space there. And one last thing to note, the container itself has no padding. If we go back to mobile landscape, we can add some padding there, so it'll affect mobile landscape and mobile portrait, so we have 10 pixels on both sides now. Now the container is providing breathing room for all the content inside. Tablet remains unaffected, it only affected the mobile breakpoints. Now what about our viewport height? We set 100 VH, but as we resize, we can note something here. Things are getting scrunched off the screen. That's because regardless of the section's content, its height is being set at 100 VH. We did this back in desktop. If we select that section, we can click to remove 100 VH. We can remove this style altogether and instead set the minimum to 100 VH. And what this will do is it'll still respect the content inside. But if the viewport isn't tall enough, it's not going to clip the content. You can see as we scroll, the section respects the content inside. But it'll also never get shorter than 100 VH. That's using minimum to set VH. Responsiveness looks pretty good, but we're seeing some overlap on the top with the phone and the logo. We can use our lower navigation to select our grid, this is the parent, and we can affect padding and margin on that. So we'll add some padding on the top to push everything down. Maybe we also want to adjust the maximum width of the image. We can set that maximum and continue to make adjustments to the padding and the margin. So the heading, if we decrease its size and its line height, we can see everything's looking a little more reasonable on mobile portrait. It's not taking up as much space in a very limited real estate view. Continually tweaking to make sure everything looks just right. Something to note though with our sections. If we go over to tablet, it looks fine centered, but starting here, it might be easier to select the section itself and align everything to the top, then just push off with padding on the inside of the section. If we look at mobile portrait here, it looks a lot better. Test responsiveness again, and maybe make an adjustment to the heading. We see a little bit of extra margin, so we can remove the margin, make it 0 pixels on mobile portrait. Now that we've created our hero section, and now that we've made it responsive, we can publish. Seriously, this can serve as a landing page already. You can stop here. But we're going to continue building the full page, starting in the next video.